Hi! Welcome back to my channel! Not forget to like, comment and subscribe before you go! Thank you! Eleanor Lee is a Singaporean actress and singer based in China. She was born on October 12, 1999, in Taiwan, Taipei. Her height is 168 centimeters or 5 feet 6 inches and currently signed under MediaCorp Taiwan. Eleanor studied in an international school in Singapore and also took up studies at Beijing Film Academy. Her parents are both artists, Kwan Yifong and Peter Yu, but got divorces in 2009 and they both share custody. If you are wondering that her surname is Lee, which is different from her paternal parents, she actually was adopted by her godfather, Addy Lee, who is a famous celebrity hairstylist in Singapore. It was on her 14th birthday that she announced the adoption of her godfather's surname. Prior to becoming an actress, she received education at Tao Nan School, then to Nexus International School Singapore. It was in 2017 that she got admitted to Beijing Film Academy. In 2014, Apple's China branch was auditioning for someone to star as the female lead in their microfilm, The Old Record. They were unable to find a suitable candidate. Addy Lee chanced upon the news and recommended Eleanor to audition for the role. In the end, she was selected. When The Old Record was released on February 2, 2015, she garnered a huge amount of attention from the public and was subsequently signed to Beijing Summer Star Media. Since then, Lee was constantly involved in filming advertisements and dramas in China, and in 2015, she was chosen by Cao Dun to play the younger version of Xu Lu's character in Tribes and Empires, Storm of Prophecy. In November 2015, Lee collaborated with Wu Chang, producing two pieces of artwork that were to be sold at $13,500 each. She then released her first song, Qing Yan Xu with Wu Jinyu, as the theme song of Noble Aspirations. In March 2017, she starred as one of the leads in Salasso Bistro, based on the Japanese drama, A Restaurant with Many Problems. In June 2017, she was cast as a female lead in the Chinese drama, Overseas Security Officer, alongside Leon Lai. In September 2017, Lee played the female lead in the campus drama, The Big Boss. In October 2017, she released her first single, That Girl. She continued to release two more singles the same year, Ink Pen and Eraser, as well as a self-composed single titled Be Together. In 2018, Lee was cast in the Chinese fantasy drama, My Poseidon, alongside actor Zhang Yimong. It was followed by the youth healing drama Blowing in the Wind alongside Xing Zhelin. In 2020, Lee starred in the romance fantasy web film, The Enchanting Phantom, adapted from the 1987 film A Chinese Ghost Story. She also starred in the youth romance drama My Love, Enlighten Me, and historical romance drama Fake Princess. I initially noticed Eleanor Lee from her drama, The Big Boss and The Big Boss 2, with Hwang Joon-ji. I found this drama by coincidence on YouTube and just wanted to try and watch just for one episode. Then I got hooked and the next thing I know, I finished the drama and even its sequel within consecutive days. She was so funny and matches well with her male lead, Hwang Joon-ji, in this case. The drama contains friendships, little romance, and family themes. The leads and supporting characters are well written combined with funny effects. It was refreshing to watch, especially with the comedic scenes. I really like Eleanor here because her acting is amazing and natural. For sure, you will also be watching the sequel as soon as you finish the first season just like me. Because the first season lacks romantic scenes and with the great chemistry between the leads, I was also hoping for a sweet kiss between the two in season 2. This time in season 2, the female lead played by Eleanor turns 18 and I was so glad that there were more interactions with the leads. The drama still has not lost its cuteness and comedic scenes, which I was happy about, otherwise I would have dropped the drama. I wanted it to be the same as refreshing as the first season but with more romantic sweetness of the characters. Luckily both characters still maintain their personality but with a little maturity in the sequel. The ending was good too, but I was actually expecting more, but hey, as long leads mutually understand each other's feelings, then I'm fine with it. In 2019, she also starred in Blowing in the Wind, with Xing Zhaolin. A group of young people with a love for mountaineering, who face their fears and take a step forward in an inspirational journey through life. Lin Feng, played by Eleanor Lee, is a university student who hopes to bring back the glory days of the mountaineering club. She meets Shadi, a member of the previous mountaineering club. The two realize that they have similar hopes and dreams and that their relationship dates further back 5 years ago. It becomes a catalyst for a story about love and salvation, growing up and letting go. The mountaineering plot is interesting and ignited my curiosity. I was hoping for an explosion of chemistry between the leads as I was a fan of their previous works. However, it didn't actually meet my expectations. Both artists, Eleanor Lee and Xing Zhaolin, have shown exceptional talent in their previous dramas, so my expectations were high. However, the script fails to use their talents to the fullest because the story got stuck with conflicts that were so easy to solve yet were obviously dragged. Their interactions looked more to be of a platonic but very close friendship than a romantic one. It would have been better if they have included some funny scenes or hilarious supporting actors, but no, they did not. But don't get discouraged by my review, because if you really like both Eleanor Lee and Zhaolin, then go ahead and watch it. Have you watched any more of her dramas? Drop a comment below and let me know. Pretty little mind, people throw rocks at things that shine in life, makes love look hard. The stakes are high. Please do not forget to like, comment and subscribe before you go. Thank you. Love is all.